Hey everybody, in this video I'm going to show you how to make an old iMac, just like this one, run much faster. So up until last week, Apple has been selling iMacs with old spinning hard drives, which is absolutely crazy, it's a scam. And essentially that means that this tutorial will work for anyone with a 2012 iMac all the way up until a 2019 iMac. In fact, if you bought a 2019 iMac last month, you're going to find this tutorial helpful too. So this is the old family computer. It has all the trimmings of a family computer. We got signage showing where the Wi-Fi symbol is. We've clearly used the chin of it as a notice board. So this has been an iMac that's been, it's been through a lot, we'll just say. Check out this startup test. As you're going to see, the iMac is incredibly slow. It will take 2.5 minutes for the iMac to get to the login screen. And it'll take an additional 20 seconds to log into the profile, giving a total of a 3 minute startup time, which is absolutely insane. And using the computer, the performance is not any better. It took 20 seconds for Google Chrome to load. What we're essentially going to do is put an SSD inside the iMac. Now, iMacs are very, very hard to upgrade because they're all in ones. So we're actually not technically going to put this inside the iMac. Instead, we're going to use an external SSD enclosure like this one that is powered by USB. Now, that's the reason why it has to be a 2012 iMac or newer, because your iMac has to have USB 3.0 ports. If the USB ports are 2.0, you're not going to get a speed increase. So for this video, we're going with the cheapest option possible, which was like an external USB enclosure, which I got off Amazon for about 15 quid. If you have more money to spend, I would recommend you just get a proper external SSD, like one of these from SanDisk or Samsung. The reason why, not that they're gonna be more reliable, but they're probably gonna be a lot faster. And they probably are gonna be a lot more reliable because the manufacturer had complete control over it, whereas we're really mixing and matching brands here and different things. For example, if you have a 2019 iMac or one of the newer iMacs where, you know, you've recently spent a lot of money on it and you're not getting the performance, then I'd highly recommend you get one of these proper USB SSDs. But if you have a really old iMac, like a 2012 or a 2013, then going the route with an external SSD and enclosure is absolutely fine. It's a great way to save some money and obviously boost the performance of the iMac. Also, while it might sound daunting to have an external hard drive powering your iMac on the outside, these are so lightweight, you can do a lot of things. For example, you can put Velcro onto these and literally attach it to the back of the iMac so it's always going to be on it, particularly if you use one of the smaller SSDs, I recommend it. So before we go ahead and install anything, let's make sure that the SSD plays nice with the iMac. So we're going to go ahead and plug it in now, and hopefully an external hard drive should pop up on the desktop. So that one just has. It's my old hard drive, which means I need to format it first, but obviously if you buy a new one, it should be good to go. Open Disk Utility, make sure you select the external hard drive under the External tab, hit Erase, give the hard drive a name, and then press Erase. One last thing you should check is inside the System Information Profiler is that the hard drive is running at 3.0 speeds, which is what you want. And as we can see here, it is, as the speed is up to 5 gigabytes a second. So this hard drive will give us fast performance. We're done on the desktop, so go ahead and turn the computer off. Now that we know the external hard drive is working, the next step is to install the new macOS 10 operating system onto your external hard drive. That's going to be much faster. So the way to do this, now I'm using a PC keyboard, but if you have your Apple keyboard, it's Command, Alt, Or. And if you're on a Windows keyboard, it's the Windows symbol, Alt, and Or. So once we turn it on, we're going to hit those three keys immediately. So here we go. So I'm holding the three keys down, and very shortly we should see that an internet symbol will pop up. So as you can see, it says starting internet recovery. This may take a while. There are other ways to go about it. You could put macOS 10 onto an external USB thumb drive. Depending on the speed of your internet connection, this may take a little while, so do be patient. When it's finished loading, you'll be greeted with this screen. Here you can do different things. If you haven't already formatted the hard drive, you can open up Disk Utility and format it. However, we already done that. If you have a Time Machine backup, you could also restore that onto your new external hard drive. But we're going to go ahead and do a clean install of the operating system. Since I recommend doing this on a 2012 iMac or newer, it should automatically update to macOS Catalina, which is the latest version of macOS 10. Follow the instructions. And here you should see your new external hard drive. You can see that symbolized by the yellow icon. do not select your old hard drive. You want to select the new one. Press it, and then just press install. The latest version of macOS will be installing onto your new external SSD. The first time the iMac restarts, it might accidentally restart into your old hard drive. So hold the Option key when the chime hits, and then select the external hard drive. It will keep installing, but do be patient. This will take a while. Eventually, you'll be welcomed with this screen, so select the country that you're from, along with all your other details. Follow the instructions, agree, create a user account. The iMac will eventually be set up, and you should see this. All going well, you should find yourself back on the desktop with a brand new installation of macOS Catalina on your external USB SSD drive. It is so much faster than the internal hard drive, and wait till you see the results for yourself. Doing the same startup test, you're going to be surprised by how quickly this computer turns on. As you're about to see, we're going to reach the login screen in about 34 seconds. Amazingly, it'll only take 40 seconds for the computer to start up, a vast improvement from the original 3 minutes from the internal hard drive. In addition, the computer is much faster. Google Chrome loads instantly, for example. So yeah, it's much faster, like just even popping around, opening up different things, it's just everything's smoother. There's no way to describe it. It's pretty shocking that Apple has been still putting those really slow hard drives inside their iMacs for years now, all the way up until basically last week. And that's just absolutely insane to me. So again, if you have a 2012 iMac or newer, all the way up to 2019, this will work for you. This is a great solution. Because ultimately, these are still really fast machines. They have quad-core processors, 8 gigs of RAM. The hard drive was like a huge bottleneck, like an unbelievable bottleneck that probably made your computer feel really ancient. Whereas you can see here, it's just going really smooth, really fast. So yeah, if you're unfortunate and you bought your iMac off the shelf and you didn't configure it to have an SSD on the inside, this is a great solution to have SSD speeds on an iMac without having to open it up and go through that whole intense process. So this has been a great solution for our family desktop computer. It's extended its lifespan by at least another 3 years. We'll probably wait for Apple to come out with the new iMacs with the Apple processors and then upgrade. But yeah, like this computer was like nearly ready to be thrown out, and this SSD has just completely transformed it. So it really does change a lot of things. And I think overall this solution has costed me about maybe 35 euro. It was very inexpensive and the results were just amazing. If you're gonna follow this tutorial too, do leave a comment below and let me know if there's anything I can do to help you. I'll be sure to do that. And also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to stay tuned for future videos. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all in my next one. Bye.